tying the knot is one of the most exciting and important events in anyone's life. Marriage, after all, is an ultimate expression of devotion to your partner. And with the pageantry of ceremony, getting hitched is definitely something worth remembering. In some Western countries, getting married is as easy as finding someone to officiate the ceremony, as well as finding a good caterer to make sure that your guests are fed to their heart's content. Of course, in an open bar. However, in many countries in the world, the ritual of marriage has multiple layers leading up to the big day itself. And as with customs and traditions around the world go, there is really no shortage of strange ones that many of us might cringe at or even be shocked by. These wedding traditions, however, have been put into practice for hundreds, if not thousands, of years by their respective cultures to symbolically strengthen the bond between spouses and bring luck to their future together. So in this video, we're gonna count down to 10 wedding traditions around the world that some may find strange and bizarre, but are nonetheless spectacular and, to say the least, romantic. Number 10, bride napping. Throughout the centuries, kidnapping women to take home as a bride was a common practice, unfortunately, among ancient civilizations from ancient China to the Romans. Bride napping is one secure way of making sure that political alliances are forged and lineages are preserved and continue on. Called take a young woman and run away, this custom still exists among certain communities in Kyrgyzstan, where the man abducts the woman he wishes to marry while accompanied by his friends or his male relatives. He then takes the woman to his home where she is kept in a room until the man's female relatives convince her to wear a specific kind of scarf for the occasion that would signify her acceptance and consent to the marriage. Number 9, beating the groom's feet. One of South Korea's long-standing wedding traditions, the beating of the groom's feet happened at the end of the wedding ceremony. The groom is taken by his friends who bind his feet in rope or sash. His footwear is removed and the men around him begin to beat the soles of his feet with a stick or a fish. The belief is that by continually beating the groom's feet, his friends are preparing him before he consummates his marriage with his wife by making him stronger. These days, the ritual is less ceremonial than it is a wholesome activity, but it's still an integral part of the Korean custom of marriage, where friends and relatives ask the groom questions and trivia while his feet are bound and lightly tapped with a stick. Number 8, this is kind of gross, spitting on the bride. The Maasai nation of Kenya has one of the most bizarre wedding rituals that is still practiced today. As part of the wedding ceremony, the bride is asked to shave her head and lamb fat and oil is applied to her scalp, after which the father of the bride blesses her by spitting on her head and breasts. In Western culture, of course, spitting is a sign of disgrace and disgust. However, the belief of the Maasai people is that it brings good fortune to the newlyweds. The bride, according to custom, must not look back as she leaves with her husband for fear that she might turn to stone. The husband is also forbidden to stay in the home of the bride for the next 2 days. At the end of this seemingly long ritual, the mother-in-law shaves her head, thus commencing the wedding ceremony itself to bind the man and woman in matrimony. Number 7, kissing the bride and groom. In almost all wedding traditions, the kiss is exclusively reserved for just the bride and the groom at the end of the ceremony. In Sweden, however, the kiss may not be as exclusive as you may think. Seemingly unique to the Swedish culture, when the groom leaves the room for any reason, all unmarried men are allowed to approach the bride and kiss her. Just to be fair, I guess the same goes for the groom. When the bride exits the room to say freshen up, all unmarried women present at the wedding is allowed by tradition to kiss the groom. Number 6, fat farms. While many women in the West try to avoid calories before their big day, the women of Mauritania adhere to a wedding custom that encourages them to so-called fat farms. Between the ages of 5 and 15, young women are encouraged to put on some weight before their wedding day to the point of almost being overweight. It is the belief of the people of Mauritania that if a bride has a significant amount of weight, then that means that her husband was wealthy enough to keep her happy and satisfied. It is also strongly believed by them that if a bride was heavy, then her marriage will be filled with good luck and prosperity. Unfortunately, many fathers of the bride abuse this custom, oftentimes force feeding their daughters to the point that they begin to develop health problems. Number 5, the wall of bridesmaids. I've actually seen this firsthand. It is not pretty. In China, in order for a groom to get to his bride, he must first prove his devotion to his bride by trying to break through a blockade of bridesmaids. Before he could walk his wife to be down the aisle, he must first complete whatever task the bridesmaids will ask of him. The tasks range from a variety of things, from questions about the bride to outright asking for money from the groom. This tests the hardiness and conviction of the groom to marry the bride. After all, once you have broken through a horde of bridesmaids, it's smooth sailing from that point on. And trust me, it really is. I've seen crazy games like, hey groom, eat a wasabi sandwich, or drink a Coca-Cola with soy sauce in it. All right, moving on to number 4, the courting hut. Native South Africans have an interesting interesting way of allowing the spouses to be to get to know each other. Certain tribes allow their women to enter what they call a courting hut, where the bride-to-be may entertain potential spouses in privacy and away from the prying eyes of her friends, family, and neighbors. It's not a bad idea since this gives both sides an opportunity to get to know each other without the added distractions of the outside world. Number 3, crying ritual. This may be one of the strangest wedding traditions that is still practiced today by the Tujia people of China. Wedding preparations begin as early as 30 days before the big day, and it starts with the bride spending an hour of each day, you guessed it, crying. After 10 days of weeping in solitude, she is joined by her mother, and 10 days after that, her grandmother. This continues until all the female members of the family are in tears for an hour every day until the big day. Though this may seem like an act of sadness, the Tujia people weep more for joy for the bride in this new chapter in her life. It is also believed that with the chorus of weeping and the different tones of voices unique to each individual, the crying would sound like almost a song to the family. Number 2, tree marrying. In India, it is believed that women born under a certain astrological period are cursed. So should these women decide to marry, they bear the consequence of being widowed every time until the curse is lifted. Now, in order to counteract that, these women would first, well, they would marry a tree, believing that the tree will absorb the curse, and once the ceremony is done, it will be cut down, leaving their human wives free from the bondage of their curse. Finally, number 1, the matrimonial ink. In the Arabic, African, and Indian cultures around the world, the tradition of getting ornate henna tattoos is a custom that dates back thousands of years. While it is not entirely bizarre, it certainly is one of the most beautiful customs to be practiced even to this day. In Western cultures, such as the Americas and Europe, women take great pains to prepare and make sure that they look stunning on their wedding day, sometimes hiring an entire army of hairdressers and makeup artists. But the custom of henna tattoos is fairly simple. Brides-to-be will get henna tattoos before their wedding day as a symbol of their elegance, as well as an artistic expression of their beauty. So I think these are really good things to know, because nowadays people are often marrying outside of their ethnicity, outside of their culture. So I guess if you're marrying somebody from Sweden, don't ever leave the room. And if you're marrying somebody from China, yeah, work up that wasabi tolerance. All right, guys, thank you all so much for watching this video. See you later.